Hello, good morning. Today I am going to discuss about string. We have already discussed different type of data types. We have primitive data types and reference data type. Okay, the string what we are going to discuss is nothing but it is a reference data type. So before going to discuss what is a reference data type and all those things, first of all discuss how many type of strings are there and basically what is it. We have character constant. 1, A, B, different character constants are there. But these are the primitive data items. But when more than one characters are kept enclosed within double quote, they become the string constant. For example, if I write A, B, C within double quote, they become the string constant. Single A is a character constant. 1 is a character constant. But when I keep A within double quote, 1 within double quote, it is known as a string constant. In a simple definition, if you want to know, then it is when one or more characters are kept enclosed within double quotes, then it is known as a string constant. When the characters are kept enclosed within double quotes, they become the object of a string class. So here I want to tell you that string, basically string, string is the name of a predefined class, that is string class. When anything is kept enclosed within double quote, that become the object of the string class. Okay, we have different type of string. Sometimes we enclose alphabets within double quote, sometimes we enclose numbers within double quote, and sometimes we enclose both alphabets and numbers within double quote. Based on this, strings are of three types. One is alphabetical string. If you say only alphabets, suppose school is kept enclosed within double quote, it is a alphabetical string. Suppose 125 is kept enclosed within double quote, it is known as a numeric string because a number is kept enclosed within double quote. Suppose I mix both alphabets and numbers, date 29th May. It is the combination of alphabets and numbers, so it is known as alphanumeric string. So depending upon the characters we use, it is of three types: alphabetical string where only alphabets present, numerical string when a number is kept enclosed within double quote, known as numeric string. When alphabets and numbers both kept enclosed within double quote, then it is known as alphanumeric string. In a numeric string, you cannot do any type of arithmetical calculations. Arithmetical calculations cannot be performed on numeric string. For example, 125 plus 5 if I write, then I will get 130. But if I double quote, I will make it string by keeping them, enclosing them within double quote, then the output will be 1255. Because here the strings will be concatenated, the string will be joined together. So this is a string concatenation or joining of strings. That means no arithmetical calculations can be performed on numeric string. Okay, so now we will learn how to create a string. Only one process I told, that when anything is kept enclosed in double quote, then it is known as string. But now think of a variable data, variable. Suppose in A, 5 is 2. I want to convert A into string. I cannot keep enclosed A within double quote because A is a variable. Okay, so that is why there are different methods to convert the data into string. The first method is what type of data you are going to convert, whether you are going to convert a constant or a variable. If you are going to convert a constant into a string, then simple, you can keep them enclosed within double quotes. As I told, 25 is a constant, so you can convert it into string by keeping them within double quote, and you can assign this to a string variable. You can write in this way, string s is equal to 25. That means directly if you are constant, then you can enclose them within double quote and assign it to a string variable. So the constants can be converted into string by enclosing them within double quotes. Suppose you have a variable. Variables cannot be cannot be enclosed in double quote to convert them into string. That's why to convert a variable into string, there are two different methods. One method is using the string class. As I told, string is an object of string class. When anything is kept enclosed in double quote, that becomes the string and that becomes the object of the string class. So we know how to create the new object by using the operator new. So a constant can be converted into an object of string class by using the operator new. So this is like this. String is the name of the class, variable is s is equal to new string. Here you can take any variable or constant. I can take a, so a will be converted into string. So this one can be a variable or a constant. If you are going to convert a constant into string, then you can use the new operator and you can convert it into an object of string class. So now a is converted into string and will store in the variable s. There are some other methods also. When you are discussing about the wrapper class, each wrapper class consists of two string method. So using the two string method of a wrapper class, you can convert a constant into or a primitive data into string. But that time you have to take specific wrapper class of a specific function. For example, if you are going to convert an integer into wrapper into string, then you have to use two string method of integer wrapper class. If you are going to convert a float data into string, then you have to use two string method of float wrapper class. For example, suppose an integer, say a is equal to int, a is equal to 129, I am going to convert a into string by using wrapper class method. String variable is equal to 129 and integer, I am going to convert integer into string, then I have to take the two string method of integer wrapper class, that is string s is equal to integer dot to string a. So in this way you can convert a two string method of different wrapper classes to convert a data or a variable into a string constant. Okay, so there are the different methods to convert a string. First of all, repeat, if the data is a constant, so directly you can enclose them within double quote and assign it to string variable, first point. Second one, you can use the new operator with the string class to convert a data into the object of string class. Third, you can use the corresponding wrapper class to convert a integer or a float or a boolean value into string using this method. As I have converted an integer into string, I am using the two string method of integer wrapper class and assign it to a string variable, that is string s is equal to integer dot to string. So after the string is created, different type of manipulations can be done on it. But as string is nothing but it is an object, directly manipulation cannot be done in it. To perform any type of manipulation, or if you want to extract any information from it, then you have to use the methods of the string class. As I told, the string is a class. It contains number of methods. Using those methods, you can get any information from the string, or you can do any type of manipulation on the string. So different methods are there. We will discuss one by one. First, we will discuss length function. There is a function length, L-E-N-G-T-H, length function. This is a method of string class. It's a method of string class used to find number of characters present in a string, or it count length of the string. Okay, it is used to find length of the string. So this length function, it doesn't take any input, but it refers to the string object and it returns an integer. Length is an integer, returns an integer. Okay, syntax is like this. It as it return an integer int, variable is equal to string whose length you are going to find, string dot length. This one, for example, int A is equal to S dot length. S dot length. If S is equal to, suppose S is equal to butterfly. B-U-T-T-E-R-F-L-Y. If S is equal to butterfly, then A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Value of A is equal to 9. So it is used to find number of characters present in a string. Okay? You have to remember the syntax. A, the string function takes no length function takes no input. It returns a value of type integer. Okay? Int A is equal to S dot length and A is equal to 9. This is about the length function. Another important function is your trim. Another important function is trim. T-R-I-M. Trim. T-R-I-M. Trim. Trim. Trim means it is a function of string class used to remove the spaces present before and after the string without disturbing the spaces present in the middle of the string. So the trim function is used to remove the spaces present before and after the string. It takes no input, okay, it takes no input and returns a string. After removing the spaces, just it returns the string. For example, syntax is string variable is equal to string dot trim. Dot trim. So this function takes no input and returns a string. For example, string S is equal to, suppose there is a space I have given fly. There is another space here, two spaces are there, dot trim, trim. So string, there are two spaces are there in S. So after the function is statement is executed, the value of S will be fly, but you will not find spaces before and after the string. So trim function is used to remove all the spaces present before and after the string without disturbing the space character in the middle. Suppose the string is like this. Here there is a space. How is it? Suppose it is like this. There is a space here. So after the statement is executed, only this space will be removed. But the space in the middle will remain unchanged. Okay, this space will remain unchanged. Only the first space will be removed. So this is about the trim function. There is another function known as caret. Another function, caret. Car at. Another function, car at, means character at. So this is a, this function is used to find a character present at a given index position. Present at a given index position. Index means the characters of a string or number starting with 0, known as the index position. Each character has the position. This is the first position, second position, third position, fourth position, fifth, sixth, seventh, eighth, ninth position. Okay, 0 position, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 position. So this is the index position. Counting starts from 1, whereas index starts from 0. So caret function is used to find the character present at a given index position. It takes one input, that is a character. It takes one input, that is a character, and returns. It takes one input, that is an index, sorry. It takes one input, that is an index, and returns a character. Okay. So what it returns? It returns a character. You take the variable is equal to the string dot caret. Caret, here the index. here the index. Okay, character variable is equal to string dot caret index. Okay, example, car c is equal to, suppose this is our string s dot caret, say 4, caret 4, c is equal to s dot caret 4, then the value of c will be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, e, value of c is e. So caret function takes one input, that is an index, and returns a character. Caret function takes one input, that is an index, and returns a character. Car c is equal to s dot caret 4. The fourth character, the character index at 4 means the fifth character. Index 4 means fifth character. The fifth character is e. So e will be stored in c. Okay, all those functions are required to write develop programs. So you should know the use of the function as well as the syntax. Okay, without knowing the syntax, you cannot able to write the program. So today we have discussed what is a string, how many types of strings are there, okay, and how to create a string by using different methods. Okay, then these three methods, string, len, and caret. So thank you very much. Next class we will discuss other functions of the string, then after we will discuss the program. Thank you very much.